Can I just say, vocalists are not playing games. Yes, Yuta. This is Karen, and right now I'm excited to be reacting to NCT 127's music video for Superhuman. This has been a long-awaited comeback. I feel like they've been teasing us for this particular comeback for like weeks now, like almost a month. I feel maybe it's been a bit less than that, but it felt like a month. I've already listened to the mini album. I listened to it at work today, so I'll talk about that later on. But yeah, without further ado, let's jump right into this. In the 3, 2, and 1, let's go. I'm really excited for the song because the teaser for it sounded amazing. I know they performed already, but I never checked it out. And this MV? Have you seen this production? Alrighty. Loving the harmony. Loving this like electronic synth bass going on. Okay, let's get the English lyrics. Jaehyun looks really good. Okay, Jungwoo. Oh. I'm really liking this section of the song. Oh my, listen, my babes looks fine. Yes! Okay, Yuta, okay, wow. Get it, Mark. Yes! Get it. Yes, Teo. Okay, hey, Sean, I see you in the corner. Ooh, that was a nice pause. Are you seeing this choreo? Listen, Jaehyun, I needed you to like stop. Like, just how dare you? Ooh. It feels like if the producers of EXO's Lucky One and Tempo came together and made this song. Listen, this choreo, this right here, yes! Yes! I'm just loving this whole futuristic look. Also, the robots remind me of that film with Will Smith. Was it iRobot? I Am Robot? Something like that. Listen, Daeyoung. I really like the pacing of this song. But the production is really nice. Get it, Johnny! Okay! Get it, Teo! This MV, wow. There are so many levels to this song. Bloody hell. Listen, Taeyo looks so good. Yes! Yes! Loving this choreo. Can I just say, vocalists are not playing games. Yes, Yuta. Listen, look at my baby Mark. Yes, you better cut it up. Jaehyun. This is my kind of production, man. Yeah. All right. Get your the Superhuman on. Like, what on earth? Oh, this is really, really good. This is really, really, really good, and we have to watch it again because. Do you hear those vocals? Do you hear that production? Do you just oh, let's listen to it again. In a three, and a two, and a one, let's go. Let's just. There's so many levels to this song. Like, I feel like it went through so many changes, but it was so understated, and it just worked really, really well. You tell the budget for this video was hella huge. That opening part seals the deal right away. This oh, this intro formation as well. I love a sick bass line, man. I wish they messed up Jungkook's hair a little bit. They kind of gave him the same hairstyle they gave Chen for tempo. Listen, Taeyo, come on, baby. See this part? You see Yuto? Yeah. They sound amazing on this track. Yes. Hey Chan, I see you, baby. This part is just so sick. That's just oh, and then it changes again. It doesn't even sound like the first verse. It almost sounds like it should be a bridge, but it's not. Ooh, did you hear that? That was nice. Yes! Come on! Yes! Hey-chan is giving me everything. This is my kind of production. This is the kind of music I live for. Hey. Listen, this is a track. This is such a good song. Okay, this is the actual bridge, I believe. I think so, yeah. Oh, yes, they are. And maybe that wasn't a. I don't even know what the bridge was. If you guys can pinpoint where that was, let me know. Yes! Oh, the beats are so sick. Listen, it's changed like a good 10 times now. Like they said, you want a roller coaster? We're gonna give you all the roller coasters in one song. Yes! Love that part. Yes, Jungkook! Yes, Hyejin! Oh, that part is so sick! Yes, we love a good harmony. And the good use of auto-tune as well. Taeyo, you better. Yes! Oh, that was sick. That was a really cool formation. I like that. Yeah! Yes! They did that. This is one of their best title tracks. It really showcased how great they can be at harmonizing and just all of them singing, you know, in a chorus, and just there were so many levels. Like, obviously, the producers were having so much fun with this track because they literally just chucked every single thing in. It sounded so good. Like I said, it reminded me of like Lucky One and Tempo, and a bit of Shinee's Married to the Music, like that kind of like production. Like, very funky with like the synthesizers and the bass and everything, like that kind of funky type of EDM. And just great harmonies, brilliant pauses, brilliant R&B trap parts as well to kind of slow it down. There were just so many moments, like there were so many highs and lows, but they were all so seamlessly put together that you just didn't care. You were just, it was just the best way to be like thrown off a loop and then brought back into the song. I just absolutely loved it. Like I knew from the moment I heard the teaser, I was like, I'm gonna like this song because it's just like the kind of pop tracks I love. And they definitely didn't disappoint. Really, really amazing. Shout outs to producers, they absolutely killed it on the production. Shout outs to the boys, they sounded so amazing. Like the vocals were really shining through. The rap parts I also really, really enjoyed as well, but I think the rappers were singing it as well in certain parts. So yeah, everyone did such a fantastic job. I don't even care too much about the line distribution because it was just so good, and it was such a long song. It was a 4:13 song, which is usually quite long than what they usually have. So yeah, thoroughly enjoyed this. Like I can't fault it, I really can't. But yeah, let's talk about the album. So yeah, I listened to it twice at work, and I really liked it. Actually, I really like it, with the exception of Paper Plane. But Paper Plane is not even like a bad song or anything like that. It's just like not my kind of vibe, because I was like going through, we had so I started with Highway to Heaven. I didn't listen to it when the MV came out. I still haven't seen that MV, by the way. And that is one of the best pop tracks ever that they've ever done. Like, it's such a good pop track. I was listening to this, I was like, yes, give me everything. It was so, there was like an, it felt like an anthem, but it also felt like it just, I don't know, it just felt amazing. Like I listened to it, I was like, oh yes, I just want to like get up, wave my hands from side to side. It was just such an amazing track, and great way to introduce me to the mini album. And I think the next one was Fool, which I really liked. It actually reminded me of Shinee's Romance, like the way it starts off, and a bit of like some of the sort of like more up-tempo tracks or mid-tempo up-tempo tracks in Justin Timberlake's like 2020 Experience. Like some, that I kind of got that vibe as well. So yeah, I enjoyed that. But I have to say Jet Lag is like my second favorite out of the B-sides. Like I really like Jet Lag. It reminds me of like not necessarily Knock On, but that kind of same vibe as Knock On from the Irregular album. And then I think, yeah, we had, was it Paper Plane? And then we had the outro. Outro wasn't too crazy about it. It didn't really do anything for me. But, like, now, after listening to this, the outro kind of makes sense as to why it's like that. But I'm not really going to pay attention to the outro, personally. Paper Plane, I feel like it depends on how I feel. But it's not a bad song at all. It really isn't. It's just, like, from listening to, like, the first four tracks in this as well, it just feels a little bit out of place. But at the same time, it's not really. I feel like it was pretty cohesive. I felt like it was a really good follow-up to the Regulate Repack or Regular Irregular album. So yeah, I thought this was really cohesive in that sense. But what I have to say is I hate the way SM has promoted this. Like, I really don't understand why they just didn't release the track as soon as they performed it. I personally believe they should have actually released the album before they went on the American tour, because it just makes more sense. Like, people want to see a new, obviously it was their first American tour, so they were going to see new music anyways, but like I feel like it would be more exciting if you just released the album, you know, just got that momentum going, and like, people could go to the concert and see all the tracks. I know they perform, I think they performed it at the concert anyways, but it would have made more sense where you hear the song, as soon as you hear the song you just want to go and buy the album rather than have to wait like how many weeks to hear it. And yeah, I felt like as soon as they performed it at one of the shows, they should have just released it the next day. It just made more sense. I feel like, especially with potential fans coming in, like imagine you're not an NCT fan or a K-pop fan and you watched that stage that they did and you wanted to download that album or that song and you just couldn't, you just had to, and you know, people forget. So I don't know, this whole tactic of like waiting to release albums after promoting the singles, like that works for Japanese markets and that works for the American market, but I feel like with K-pop groups, like I feel like we need to stick to the way we usually promote them, like the same marketing strategies, because it just makes more sense, especially when you're trying to, you know, attract a new audience as well. I don't know, I just feel like the SM kind of, you know, dropped the ball with the way they marketed that in general. But I still hope that people check it out. I still hope that it made a long lasting impression enough for new fans to check out this mini album as well and check out their stuff in general. But yeah, let me know your thoughts on the album, the marketing strategy that, you know, was used as well. And yeah, let me know your favorites of the album as well. But yeah, that's all I've got for you guys. If you guys enjoyed this video, and yeah, I'll speak to you later. Bye.